Esophageal atresia, or EA, occurs when a baby is born with their esophagus in discontinuity, or with a gap. Usually, the esophagus forms as a tube that connects the mouth to the stomach. In babies with EA, the esophagus develops in two separate segments that don't connect to each other. In some children, so much of the esophagus is missing that the ends cannot be easily connected with surgery. This is known as long gap EA. Many babies born with EA also have a tracheoesophageal fistula, or TEF. This is an abnormal connection between the esophagus and the trachea, which is the tube that connects the throat to the windpipe and lungs. There are four types of EA. In type A, the upper and lower segments of the esophagus end in pouches, like dead-end streets, that don't connect. A TEF is not present. In type B, the lower segment ends in a blind pouch. The TEF is present on the upper segment. This type is very rare. In type C, the most common type, the upper segment ends in a blind pouch and a TEF is present on the lower segment. And in type D, a TEF is present on both the upper and lower segments. This is the rarest form of an EA-TEF spectrum. Because of their anatomy, children with EA can't receive enough nutrition by mouth. It can also be more prone to respiratory infections, like pneumonia. That's why the best treatment for EA is usually surgery to reconnect the two ends of the baby's esophagus to each other. The Esophageal and Airway Treatment Center, Boston Children's Hospital, is one of the only programs in the country specifically designed to care for children with all forms of EA. We offer two innovative surgical approaches to long-gap esophageal atresia. In the next two videos, I'll tell you more about these two procedures, the focal process, and the new minimally invasive version of the focal process.